What's up, guys? Welcome back to All Wings Everything. Yes, I am your cook, Spinelli. Yes, the self-proclaimed wing king, of course, and the prince ruler of all lemon pepper wings. Now, if you want to learn how to make the best lemon pepper wings on the planet, click that link above me and I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. And you too can respect the lemon pepper. Now, in today's video, I got another easy recipe for you. Yes, it's getting colder outside, guys. So I'm going to show you how to make a simple pork stew. I already know you're going to love it. And if you don't eat pork, substitute it with chicken. So I hope you're in your kitchen. I'm already in mine. So let's go. All right. So here are the ingredients we're going to use for today's recipe. Yes, it is a stew, so that means it's going to be a lot of ingredients. So, but that's what it takes to make a great stew. So let me tell you what we have here. We're going to use some sweet peas. Right here, I got the mini red potatoes, vegetable oil, have some red wine. Yep, we're going to use some red wine, salt, some Old Bay seasoning. I have some tomato paste right here, crushed red pepper flakes. We're going to use some Better Than Boullion, beef Better Than Boullion, or you can use regular beef stock. We're gonna use carrots, black pepper. We have some garlic cloves here. All-purpose flour, I think I said that, but it doesn't matter. Bay leaves. We're gonna use a yellow onion. Here's our pork stew meat. Now you can buy your own pork stew meat. You can use a shoulder if you want to, and you can dice it up yourself. Like get a pork shoulder and do it. But this, I got this from Walmart and it was already chopped up for me and diced up for me, so that way I don't have to do it. And right here we have some celery. So these are the ingredients we're going to use. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so I've measured out all our ingredients. So let me tell you what we have here. So back here I got 1/3 cup of red wine. Right here I have 2 pounds of pork stew, pork meat. Like I say, you can get a shoulder and you can chop it up or dice it up into 2 pounds. Right here, I have 1 pound of red potatoes. And in this bowl, I put 1 cup of onions, 1 cup of carrots, 1 cup of green peas, and 1 cup of celery. So this is what's in this bowl. Right here, I got 3 bay leaves, and I got 1/2 teaspoon of red pepper flakes. I have 1/4 cup of all-purpose flour, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper, 1 teaspoon of salt, 2 tablespoons of tomato paste. I have 1/2 teaspoon of Old Bay seasoning, 4 teaspoons of vegetable oil, 2 tablespoons of butter, and I have about 5 garlic cloves minced here. So these are the ingredients. So guys, let's go ahead and get started. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do, of course, we're going to season our pork meat. So let me bring our starter show up here in the front so you guys can see. All right, so let's start with our pepper. Let's add our salt. Next, let's add our Old Bay seasoning and our red pepper flakes. And I'm gonna give this a good mix. I don't know if this is gonna be enough for me, especially with the amount of pork we have in here. I may have to add me a little bit more just to make sure that my meat is seasoned. And I think I am. This is not enough seasoning for me. So I'm going to sprinkle about 2 teaspoons of salt. And guys, you don't have to do this, but of course I'm going to do it. And I'm gonna probably put 2 dashes of that Old Bay back in there, along with 1 little pepper. That'll do it for me. Like we say in the South, that ought to hold you. Let's go ahead and get this flour on here too. I forgot we had to add our flour. Mix your flour in here well, like this. All right, now we're done. You can take a look at that. All right, let's move on. All right, guys, so what we're gonna do now is I've already added 2 tablespoons of our vegetable oil in here. So we're gonna bring this up to temperature. And once we get it hot, we're gonna start adding our pork stew. Okay, so we'll let this get up to temperature for about 1 minute, and then we'll continue. All right, so we're up the temperature. So what we're gonna do is start adding our pork pork meat. And the reason I'm not going to dump it all in here is because we want to make sure that we only have one layer. We don't want to, you know, overcrowd the pan by having the pork on top of each other. So if you have to work this in batches, work it in batches. But, you know, you don't want to sit it all on top of each other. And typically you're going to let this cook for about 5 minutes. And you want it to brown on all sides. So with these 2 pounds that I have, obviously I'm going to have to cook it in maybe about 2 batches. All right, guys, we're gonna let this cook about 2 or 3 more minutes. Should be there. All right, guys, so looks like we have the meat browned. So what we're gonna do now, I'm just gonna remove it. And I'm just gonna add it to this bowl while we cook our second batch. Right, I'm gonna add a little bit more to the other last 2 tablespoons of olive oil. I'm gonna add that in there. It's already up the temperature, so I'm just gonna start dropping in our last batch. Well, I hope this is our last batch. And of course, we're gonna do the same thing with this batch, is we're gonna cook it until it's brown for about 5 minutes, all right? I'll see you in a bit. What we're gonna do here, I'm gonna go ahead and just turn this down because I don't wanna turn it off just yet, but I think we're ready. Well, I'm gonna say, I think I know. We're just gonna take this second batch, we're just gonna add it to our first batch, the bowl with our first batch. Of course, they don't have to be cooked thoroughly because, of course, the slow cooker is going to finish cooking. We just want to give it a little color, and this is what we have. So let's go ahead and move on to the next step. I'm going to show you what we're going to do. We're just going to we're going to take all our wine, and what we're going to do is that's why I didn't turn it off. I'm going to turn the sound down because what we want to do is we want to kind of scrape the bottom of it, get all this, the driplets that's at the bottom of the pan. So I'm gonna start scraping this, guys. All right, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to take these driplets that we have, let me turn this off. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna pour this into our pan with our bowl with our pork stew meat, all right? And let's move on to the next step. All right, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna add our 2 tablespoons of butter, and we're gonna go ahead and get this melted. Now we're gonna start adding our garlic and our onions. Now, maybe I should have separated my onions because remember I put it over here, but glad I had them on top and not on the bottom. And what we'll do is we'll add those in here. If we miss a few, don't worry about it. It's not gonna be the end of the world. They're gonna soften up in the slow cooker, so we'll just leave it like that. And we're going to try to get these bad babies softened up, or get them softened up by cooking them for about a minute or two. All right, so what we're going to do now is we're going to add a cup of our beef broth, and again we're going to do the same thing. We're just going to scrape the bottom of this skillet to make sure we get all the droplets and bites. All right, so I've already turned this off. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to pull out our slow cooker, and then we're gonna continue. All right, so now I've got my slow cook out. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go ahead and dump our stew meat in here like that. Remember, we added that wine mixture in here with it. Oh man, it smells good. And not to mention, what we're gonna do next is we're going to take that broth mixture with the onions and garlic, and we're just gonna add that over the top too, just like that. And next, what we're gonna do is we're gonna start adding our peas, carrots, and celery on top of that. Also, our potatoes. Let's not forget to add our tomato paste. I'm gonna get that in here with the meat. So I should have added that before we put all that in it, but doesn't matter, it's all the same. And we're going to add the remaining 4 cups of our beef broth. Remember, we had a total of 5 cups of beef broth. Just like that. And here, you can season it with some additional salt and pepper. Let's add our bay leaves first. Me, not going to put too much salt on it, but we're going to add a little bit, maybe about a teaspoon just to start it off. We don't want it too salty, so as we cook it through, we taste as we go. A little bit of that pepper. And what we're going to do is we're going to put this bad baby to cook for about 7 to 8 hours on low. Checking it throughout the process. Of course, we're going to check it throughout the process, but for 7 to 8 hours. So let me close that up. Lock the sides and set the timer. And I'll see you guys in about 7 hours. All right. So it looks like our 7 hours is up. So I'm going to take a look at it to see if I need to cook it for an additional hour, which I don't think I'm going to have to because I've already been kind of going back and forth with it, taking a look at it. So guys, let's take a look and see what we got. Take a look at that. This is what we're looking for right here. Oh man, this looks good. It smells good. And I'm gonna go ahead and take a little taste test of it to see if it needs any salt, which I doubt because I did taste it along the way. So let's see. Nah, that is perfect. I can't even remember my salt measurements that I put in this, but I tell you, this is right on time right here. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do, get this bad baby into a bowl and I'll be right back. And there you have it, guys, a delicious pork stew. Just take a look at that. The carrots, we got the peas, potatoes. Oh man, it is, man, this thing looks fulfilling and delicious. Guys, this is the time of year in the season for the stews, the soups, the chilies to come out, and you want to add this one here to your menu. Now, before I get out of here, I want to let you know the measurements and the ingredients all in the video description below. The links to the ingredients are in the description below also. And if you need any of these items, just click it. They'll be delivered right to your door from Amazon. And guys, if you hadn't picked up that All Wings Everything merch, go ahead and do so right now. Hit that applaud button if you like this video. And if it's your first time here, please consider subscribing. I know you're going to enjoy what you see. And before I get out of here, like I said, let's go ahead and dig into this stew. All right. There we go. Let me get some of the, oh man, look at that. Oh, yes, yes. All right. Y'all ready? I know it's probably hot, so I need to be careful. Guys, I'm in heaven. And the broth is delicious. Let me get some of it with the potato and some of that pork meat. Take a look at that. The pork is tender. It has flavor. This is delicious. All right. Now, until then, I'm your cook, Spinelli, All Wings Everything, and I am out. Peace.